making way for you, making way for you to come and get your glory. Making way for you, making way for you to come and get your glory here today. Nothing can steal, nothing can stop your goodness, your glory. See the goodness of the Lord rising upon us, more surely than the dawn, more surely than the dawn, more surely. More surely than the dawn, more surely than the dawn, more surely than the dawn. See the goodness of the Lord rising, it's rising. Making way, we're making way for you to come and get your glory. Making way for you to come and get your glory. More surely dawn, more surely than the dawn, more surely than the dawn. See the goodness of the Lord rising, rising. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Oh, praise is rising as your goodness is rising upon us. Praise is rising. So rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. Rise up, my soul, rise up. Rise up, my soul, rise up to praise the risen one. To praise the risen one. To praise the risen rise, O Lord, to your resting place. Come and dwell in the praises of your people. Arise, O Lord, to your resting place. Come and dwell here. Dwell amongst our praises. Arise, O Lord, to your resting place. Oh, you inhabit the praises of your people. You inhabit the praises of your people. flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. I'm in your presence. There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence. And I've tasted and seen the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. In your presence, Lord, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord.
Push it down.
'Cause we're fighting not with our own strength, but the strength of the Lord. In our weakness, He is strong. Oh, and His grace is sufficient. And His grace is sufficient. Songs of deliverance come. We laugh as enemies run. They flee before my God. Songs of deliverance come. We laugh as enemies run. They flee before my God. Songs of deliverance come. We laugh as enemies run, they flee before my God. Songs of deliverance come, we laugh as enemies run, they flee before my God. Yeah. And victory is ours, oh, victory. You're establishing a place of praise within us, amongst us. You're strengthening a place of praise within us, amongst us. We are your people, and you are God. And you are our God. And we sing in longing. We sing in longing for the day. Truly one, we sing in longing, we sing in longing for the day when we're one, for the day we're truly one. We sing in longing, we sing in longing for the day when we're one, for the day we're truly one. Truly one, we sing in longing, we sing in longing for the day when we're one, for the day we're truly one. We wait with expectation, we wait with longing in our hearts. Oh, for you are. Establish a place of worship. 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 Establish a place of worship, establish a place of worship, establish a place of worship, establish a place of worship. Making us one, making us one, you're making us one, you're making us one, making us one, you're making us one. Oh, you're making us one. 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 Call forth the praise of your people. Call forth worship you deserve. forth the praise of your people. Call forth the worship you deserve. We call forth the praise of your people. We call forth the worship you deserve. Call forth the praise of your people. Call forth the worship you deserve. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. It's your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, It's a roar that's insane. You're giving me faith like a child, secrets as a friend, grace to believe again. You're giving me faith like a child, secrets as a friend, grace to rise up again. As your breath fans these embers into a flame, your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Your breath fans these embers into a flame, your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Say the word and it is done. Say the word and it is finished. Say the word and it is done. You say the word and it is finished. So come say the word and it is done. Come say the word and it is finished. Come say the word and it is done. Come say the word and it is finished. And let there be process you've started, it's when you've begun. You'll see till the end, you'll fight till it's done. 'Cause you know the end from the beginning. You're in no rush, no anxiety. Oh, my sweet Father and wise Shepherd, you lead me in perfect peace. My sweet Father and wise Shepherd, embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Your breath Softens these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's insane. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's intense. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Your breath fans these embers into a flame. Your voice is a whisper, it's a roar that's untamed. Let there be light. Let there be you're driving the darkness out. 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 Driving the darkness out. Driving the darkness out. Let there be light. Let there be light.
We are now going into a time of praying and singing from the Word of God. This morning, we will be reading Romans 8, verses 1 through 8. I encourage you to find it in your Bible and join us as we meditate, sing, and pray through Romans 8. Verses 1 through 2. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. For the law of the Spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sin and death. Lord, renew our minds today and help us to really hear what your word says here. There is not any, 0%, no eternal blame, criticism, or disapproval that can stick anymore to those who are in Christ. The enemy may come and try to lie to us, but his words have no weight or authority anymore in our lives. Once we surrender our lives to Christ, we are in such a special place with you, Jesus. You love us so deeply that you died so that we could be transformed and know you intimately. Help us to see that we are free in your eyes and that you have given us a new status in heaven and a new identity as children of the King. Help us to see that the law of sin and death was defeated by the law of the Spirit of life. You now stand condemning the one who condemned us. Condemnation is your weapon now, and not the devil's, to use against your children. There is truly, therefore now, no condemnation for those who are in Christ. Convince our hearts of this truth today, and fill us with your life today.
Surrender to Christ and hidden with Christ. There's no condemnation, no condemnation. Oh, there's no condemnation, no condemnation.
0%, no condemnation.
'Cause you broke the power of sin and death. Oh, you broke the power of sin and death, Jesus. Oh, you broke the power of sin and death.
You broke it on the cross, Jesus.
Oh, you broke the power of sin and death. Broke the power of accusation. Oh, you broke the power of accusation.
Accusation cannot stand against the righteous.
Oh, you broke the power of accusation. You broke the power of accusation. You broke the power of accusation. You broke the power of accusation.
It is broken and shattered.
I stand free, free of condemnation. I stand free.
We are free in you.
I stand free, free of condemnation. I stand free, free of condemnation. You broke the power of sin and death. You broke the power of accusation.
They are broken.
You broke the power of sin and death.
are shattered.
You broke the power of accusation. You broke the power of sin and death. You broke the power of accusation. And I stand free. Disapproval in your eyes. No disappointment. No condemnation. Oh, I'm found in Christ. I'm found in Christ. Covered in. Justifying blood. When you see me, you see Christ. When you see me, you see Christ. So when you see me, you see Christ. For the law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. The law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. For the law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. The law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. The law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. The law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. The law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. The law of the Spirit of life set me free in Christ. Setting me free from the law of sin and death. I'm no longer bound to my sin and flesh.
Romans 8, 3 through 4. For God has done what the law, weakened by the flesh, could not do, by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh and for sin. He condemned sin in the flesh, in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Lord Jesus, give us new ways of understanding the freedom you bought for us with your own life. Awaken our minds and release fresh revelation on how amazing and awesome you are. From the beginning, you knew that only you could fulfill the requirements of the law and plan to do so all along. We could not be holy enough to escape condemnation, but you made us holy and righteous by taking our place of punishment. Only you could silence the voice of the one who accuses us and turn around and condemn him. You did what no one else could do so that you could remove what separated us from you. Fill your world with people who love you and bring a love revolution to the earth. Never can anyone say that anything is impossible again. Nothing is impossible with you. We long to see you move in powerful ways on this earth, in our lives, and through those who walk according to the Holy Spirit. Keep doing what seems impossible and bring the world into a place of awe of you.
I am found as a righteousness in Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For you were there at the start of time. You were there. You were there and you saw ahead. Oh, you saw that we'd need a Savior. You saw that we'd need a Savior. You saw that we'd need a Savior. So you came.
From the beginning, you knew.
You saw that we'd need a Savior. You saw that we'd need a Savior. You saw that we'd need a Savior. So you came.
From the beginning, you planned it all.
You saw that we'd need a Savior. You saw that we'd need a Savior. You saw that we'd need a Savior. And you came. You saw that we'd need a Savior, you saw that we'd need a Savior, you saw that we'd need a Savior, and you came. You saw that we'd need a Savior, you saw that we'd need a Savior, you saw that we'd need a Savior, and you came. Oh, Jesus, oh. Only you who could fulfill the righteous requirements. It's only you who could condemn sin.
Only you, God.
It's only you who could fulfill the righteous requirements that we could never meet, that we will never meet on our own. We could never meet. We will never meet on our own. We could never meet. We will never meet on our own. We could never meet. We will never meet on our own. We could never meet. That we will never meet on our own. We could never. righteous requirement. And yet you call me righteous now. Yet you call me righteous now. Oh, you call me righteous now. Yeah, you call me righteous now. Oh, you call me righteous. You call me justified. You call me righteous. You call me justified. Free of condemnation, I am found in Christ.
Yes.
Found in Christ. Free of accusation, free of condemnation, I am found in Christ.
It's our new status.
Found in Christ.
Our new identity.
Free of accusation, free of condemnation, I am found in Christ. I'm found in Christ. Free of accusation, free of condemnation, I am found in Christ. Found in Christ. Free of accusation, free of condemnation, found in Christ.
We are hidden with Christ,
found
in God.
In Christ. Found in Christ. Found in Christ. You're bringing me revelation of what this truly means. What this means for my life, and how I should see, how I should live, how I should seek and ask. 'Cause I'm free of accusation, free of condemnation, I am found in Christ, found in Christ. I am found as a blameless son. 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 Doesn't make sense. Grace and love of God, that I be found as a blameless son. Oh, as a blameless son.
You removed all the blame.
Oh, I'm found as a blameless son. A blameless son.
We are now children of the King of Kings.
Oh, the sun. Given me your status, given me your status. I'm co-heirs with Christ, I'm co-heirs with Christ. Co-heirs with Christ.
Romans 8, 5 through 6. For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh, but those who live according to the Spirit, set their minds on the things of the Spirit. For to set the mind on the flesh is death, but to set the mind on the Spirit is life and peace. Heavenly Father, I pray that you would let your word read us today. God, I pray that you would give us a heart check, that you would draw near to us right now in this moment. Search us and reveal to us where we have been placing priority and importance in our lives. Search us, O God. Am I so easily distracted by my own physical needs and emotional desires that I am missing out on the life you paid for me to have? Your word says that focusing and caring too much about the things of the flesh sets us in opposition to you and invites death into our lives. We don't want that. So we renounce all partnership with the flesh, all allegiance to the flesh. Forgive us for listening too much to what others say around us and not making time to hear what you want to say to us. Break off the fear of man today and give us the fear of the Lord. Bring us to life fully again and give us new understanding of who we are, who you made us to be, who you are, and what you are saying to us right now. Give us the grace to set our minds on you and your goodness. Let today begin a new chapter of our lives with you.
Renouncing my allegiance to the flesh.
I will not live according to the flesh.
I'm listening to your Spirit, I will walk.
The flesh has no power over me,
and there's no in between. But I'm choosing the Spirit, choosing to set my mind on you.
I take every thought captive and obeying Christ
and submitting to Christ. I will submit every thought, every emotion to your Lordship. Your perfect Lordship.
And I will honor you with my mind, Lord. And I will honor you with what I think.
Let the thoughts of my mind and the meditations of my heart to you.
And I will obey you, Lord, with all my mind. And I will obey you, Lord, with all my obey you, Lord, with all my mind. I will obey you, Lord, with all my mind.
I'm setting my mind on things above, setting my mind in accordance with your Spirit.
I want to live according to your Spirit, not according to the world, but to your Spirit.
Oh, it's easy to give in to the thoughts of the flesh, the acts of the flesh, but I'm gonna resist, I'm gonna stand my ground, 'cause I am found in Christ, I'm empowered in Christ. I am not powerless, I am not overcome.
Holy Spirit, come and renew my mind.
Oh, you are faithful to breathe renewal of the mind, faithful to bring renewal of the mind. You're faithful to bring renewal of the mind. You're faithful to bring renewal of the mind. You're faithful to bring renewal of the mind. To bring renewal of the mind.
Renew our minds today,
faithful,
oh my God.
To bring renewal of the mind.
You are faithful.
Faithful to bring renewal of the mind. Oh, I have the mind of Christ. This is the truth. This is the truth.
Romans 8:7-8. For the mind that is set on the flesh is hostile to God, for it does not submit to God's law. Indeed, it cannot. Those who are in the flesh cannot please God. Almighty God, you are the King and all supreme God of the universe. Your ways are holy and judgments right. You are all-knowing and all-powerful. You have existed before time began, and you will always be. You are good and you are loving. You don't see as the world sees, but have very different eyes and a very different value system. You care about all of the huge global events around us. And you're always there for each of your children when we call. There is none other that we would rather surrender our lives to because we feel safe in your hands. Lord, I pray that our trust and dependence on you will shake the earth today and will soften the hearts of those who are openly living in hostility to you. Break into their lives and woo them as you did each of us. Your word says that without faith, it is impossible to please you. Melt their hearts today as you crash into their lives, introducing them to the gospel and the great lengths that you have gone to demonstrate your love for them. May we hear countless testimonies of those who were hostile to you coming to faith in Christ and into the kingdom of God in the future. Move with your power. Move with your fire, Almighty God.
Oh, you see the your mind set on the flesh, and it breaks your heart. Oh, it breaks your heart to see those living in the flesh, not able to see, not able to receive your love. So God, we cry out. Oh God, we cry out that in your mercy you would soften hearts, that in your mercy you would draw near to those who don't yet know your love, who don't yet know your spirit, who don't yet know the freedom found in you. Oh, come, won't you come?
Soften hearts today.
Oh, reveal yourself and reveal yourself. Reveal yourself to the lost.
Open their eyes, Almighty God.
Reveal yourself. Reveal yourself. Reveal yourself to the lost.
Show them who you are in all your glory.
Reveal yourself. Reveal yourself. Reveal yourself to the lost. 'Cause it's your desire that they live pleasing to you. It's your desire that they be in communion with you. It's your desire that they would delight in the law of the Lord, delight in the joy that comes in knowing your spirit. Oh, it's your desire. This is your desire, more than any one of us could wish for, more than any one of us could cry out for. Oh, Jesus, you cry out for them.
Yes, God.
The great high priest, you cry out for them. Oh, Jesus, you cry out for them. 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 Jesus, you cry out for them.
And your cry will reach their hearts, God.
Jesus, you cry out for them. So come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours.
Break our hearts today, God.
Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Come and break our hearts for what breaks yours. Oh, Jesus, you cry out for them. Jesus, you cry out for them. Jesus, you cry out for them. Jesus, you cry out for them.
Would you come here and invade our hearts? God of peace, would you come in glory and power so that we are yours? God of peace, would you come and invade our hearts? Overcome by truth, we wanna be victors. We wanna be victors. We wanna be victors of this world. You have given us strength and power. You have given us all wisdom through Christ. Holy Spirit, come and invade our hearts. Holy Spirit, conform us to you. And we will stand against this world. We will stand against everything that's hostile to you. We will stand. We will stand against this world. No matter the cost, Lord. No matter the sacrifice, we will stand. No matter the cost, Lord. We will stand against this world. We are not of this world, but we are citizens of heaven. Give us the grace to live as your people, Lord. And we want to honor you, Lord. We want to so give us dreams, God. Give us dreams for your kingdom to come. Give us dreams to see your kingdom come. Give us dreams to see the way in which you work in our lives.
Give us dreams, God.
Give us dreams, God, to see your truth come here. And see heaven come where it's impossible for us to see. And give us dreams, God, for freedom. Give us dreams, God, for freedom. Give us freedom. Lord, we want to see. Give us dreams to see your kingdom come. Give us dreams to see salvation. Give us faith, Lord. Where we are faithless, give us faith. We submit to your plans. Give us dreams, God, to see you move.
Almighty God, we thank you for meeting with us today, for searching our hearts through your word, for drawing near to us, God, and reminding us again of who we are and whose we are and what that really means. God, I pray that you would continue to release your grace for us to step back into our place as worshipers, living lives that bring you glory. We pray that the spirit of life would have its way in our lives. We give you full authority once again. And as an act of our will, God, we choose to set our minds on the things of the Spirit today. And I pray, God, that you would give us perseverance to make this choice day after day after day after day. God, continue to give us a heart and develop a heart inside of us for those who don't know you. And I pray, God, that you would continue to work out what freedom really looks like in our lives, drawing us even closer to you in intimacy and understanding. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Now we will be going into a time of intercession through prayer topics. This morning we'll be praying for North Korea. Please come into agreement with me as I pray along with the prayer points on the screen. And then pray with your own voice as the Holy Spirit leads you. Lord, we pray for your truth and your power to move today in North Korea. We ask that you would strip away the power behind the words that they have used to define themselves as a nation. We pray for a complete reversal in thinking and identity over North Korea today. Instead of being military first, we ask that you would replace this with having value for all people in the nation. Instead of being self-reliant, we pray that you would replace this with being selfless, with a desire to partner and serve other nations. We pray for the nation to begin to value all of its people and provide for them in every physical, emotional, spiritual, and mental way. We declare new identities over North Korea, that they are a generous nation, a loyal nation, a selfless nation, a holy nation, a kind nation, a compassionate nation, a hospitable nation, and a selfless nation. Let's pray. Thank you. Almighty God, we pray that you will commandeer and ride on every word that is being spoken to North Korea this day. We ask that your power and anointing will melt and soften every heart in North Korea who is being communicated with. Your word says that you will sprinkle clean water and you will cleanse from uncleanliness, that you will remove idols, and that you will bring new hearts and a new spirit. And so we pray Ezekiel 36 over North Korea. We pray that you would move powerfully through the words that are being spoken globally. We declare anointing, fire, favor, and wisdom on those words to accomplish your perfect will at this time and in every situation. We prophesy that the warnings and advice being given to North Korea will be received in a new and fresh way, and that the cyber attacks, missile attacks, and hostility toward other nations will cease today in the spirit, because you already have the greatest victory that there ever has been. And we superimpose your kingdom over the kingdom of North Korea today. And we pray that you would release your mercy, your grace, your fire, bringing an end to the things that don't please you, and your life, bringing life and building up the things that do please you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Let us pray.
Thank you.
Heavenly Father, your word is life-changing, and it has been personally in our lives. So we pray today that you will release the power of your living and active word in North Korea. Make your written word more available to the people of North Korea, and give those who read it the grace to remember it and to hide it in their hearts, that it would be a well that they could come back to and draw from in difficult times. Speak loudly, Lord, and let your words bring comfort, peace, and healing today and every day. We declare that the word of God will be cherished in North Korea, and that God will move powerfully and encounter all who read it. Your word has told us, God, that when you speak, that you accomplish great things, that it never comes back void or empty. So we pray that you would bring great fruit, through the words that you are speaking. We pray for the word made flesh, Jesus Christ, to fill the land with his presence, flooding all the dark places, flooding all the dark places with marvelous light. Hope is alive today because Jesus is alive today and has already overcome everything on the cross. So we prophesy that God is removing all the authority of the demonic principalities in North Korea. God is removing them, and that the word of God will become the new foundation of the country. We declare that you are silencing the demonic voices that have been influencing the leaders and replacing them with your voice, and that you are taking that place of authority, Almighty God, in North Korea. Let us pray. Almighty God, there's so much going on in the world right now, and we ask that you would renew our minds today and give us grace to see as you do. We say that you are good in the middle of hard and scary times. You have abundant supply toward every problem. So we prophesy the prophetic words that have been released over North Korea just this year. We stand with them. We prophesy that a great awakening will come to North Korea, shaking the whole peninsula. Repentance will come and wash away the scales on people's eyes, removing every trace of darkness and division. That you are replacing the darkness and bringing your holy and marvelous light. We pray that justice and judgment would form stumbling blocks to every and all evil schemes, breaking off corruption and removing every idol from its throne in North Korea. We declare that revival will sweep through the land, transforming the land and bringing it to life. We declare freedom for all the captives in North Korea. And we declare that those who have been set free will be sent out as missionaries and lovers of people around the world to release that freedom and deliverance, carrying the gospel and authority and anointing, and that supernatural miracles and signs and wonders will follow. We thank you, God, that you have so many plans and desires for North Korea, and we partner with you today in our prayers, declaring life, declaring breakthrough, and declaring newness. Let us pray.
Thank you.
Almighty God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this time where we were able to pray the things on your heart, to stand in a place of authority as sons and daughters, and to declare your life, your hope, your freedom, your breakthrough over North Korea. We thank you, God, that you are moving. You are moving with great momentum, and we pray that you will take these prayers offered today and increase the momentum of the breakthrough and hasten the day when the freedom will be realized. God, we thank you that you renewed our minds and reminded us again of whose side we're really on, that we're on the victorious side, that we stand in a place of victory. God, I thank you that you have all power. Release fresh courage in us today to continue to stand and pray scary prayers, believing that you will answer them, believing that we will see you move, shift atmospheres, win spiritual battles, and transform every circumstance concerning North Korea today. God, we thank you. Thank you for bringing us into your family. Thank you for reminding us whose side we're on today. Help us to take our place and to stand. Stand in faith and hope. We thank you, God. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us today as we meditated on and prayed through Romans 8 as well as 4 North Korea. We have another watch tomorrow evening at 8 p.m. So hope you can join us then. If not, we'll see you next week. Have a great day.